Hi, welcome to the series of video lectures on microwave engineering. Today we will discuss about magic tea or hybrid tea. This article comes under unit 5 of microwave engineering subject. So this is the magic tea or hybrid tea. It consisting of a collinear arm. This is called as collinear arm. It is a 4-port device, basically port 1, port 2, port 3, port 3 and port 4. As both E arm and H arm are connected like this, if you connect both E arm and H arm, this is called as a magic tea. So this is, as I have explained in the previous lecture, what is the use of E arm and what is the use of H arm, how these arms are connected, what are the properties of these two arms, I have explained in the previous lectures. So let us see what is the operation of this. So when input is applied, when the input is applied to port 4, that is E arm. So what is the property of E arm? This input is equally divided between port 1 and port 2 of same magnitude with opposite phase from the property of E plane tilt. Similarly, when the input is given to port 3, so that is H arm, we can see that this input is equally divided into port 1 and port 2 with the same phase and no output is obtained at port 4. Let us see this again. So when the input is applied to port 4, the input is divided equally into port 1 and port 2 of same magnitude with opposite phase and no output is obtained at port 3. So this is the first property. Second property, you can say that if you apply input to port 3, it is equally divided into port 1 and port 2 with the same phase and no output is obtained at port 4. That means port 3 and port 4 are isolated ports. Let us define the S matrix of this magic tea, which will explain all the properties of this tea. See, first, since it is a 4-port junction, so this is a 4-port device, the S matrix is a square matrix of order 4x4. The S matrix is a square matrix. The S matrix is square matrix of order 4x4. So that means we have to write S matrix as S11, S12, S13. S14, S21, S22, S23, S24, S31, S32, S33, S34, S41, S42, S43 and S44. So first we have to write the S matrix is a 4x4 matrix. Second point, if port 3 and port 4 are properly matched, next point write, if port 3 and 4 are properly matched, so then what you can write, S33 is equal to S44 is equal to 0. So that is what you can write. If port 3 and port 4 are properly matched, so you can write like this, S33 is equal to S44 is equal to 0. Next, let us check out from the property of E plane T, from property of E plane T or E arm, from the property of this E arm, what you can write, S14 is equal to minus S24. S14 is equal to minus S24. This is what we can write from the property of E arm. S14 is equal to minus S24. So this is the property. So from H arm property of H plane T or H arm. So this is how it has been designed. So S13 is equal to S23. So S13 is equal to S23. We can write like this, S13 is equal to S23. Now, as I already explained that So these port 3 and port 4 are isolated ports. If you apply port at input at port 3, it will not come at port 4. Similarly, if you apply input at port 4, it will not come at port 3. So therefore, that means very, very important property. Port 3 and 4 are isolated ports. Isolated ports. So that is what you can write. That is S34. So that is equal to S43 is equal to 0. So this is another very, very important property of magic T or hybrid T, S34. So that is equal to S43 is equal to 0. So now from symmetry property, next property from symmetry property of S matrix, from symmetry property of S matrix, what we can write? Sij, the element Sij is equal to Sji. So what we can write from the this Sij element is equal to Sji from the properties of S matrix. So from this, what you can write is that first row you can keep it as this, S21 is written as S12, S22, S23 is written as S32, and S24 is written as S42. While coming to the third row, S31 is written as S13, S32 already written as S23, S33 is, keep it as it is, S34, S34 is written as S43, comma, coming to fourth row, S41 is written as S14, S42 already we have written it as S24, S43 we already written it as S34, S44. So therefore, from the symmetry property of S matrix, you can make this by equating Sij is equal to Sji. So now substitute all these values in this S matrix, all these properties in this S matrix. Let us write the S matrix as S matrix is written as after substituting all the properties of S matrix, the S matrix is written as you can see this S11 keep as it is, S12 keep as it is, S13 keep as it is, S14 keep as it is, S21 is written as S12, S22 keep it as it is, S23 is written as S13, S24 is written as minus S14, S31 is written as S13, S32 is written as S23, S23 is again written as S13, S33 is a matched port, S34 is equal to 0 because the port 3 and port 4 are isolated ports, S41 is written as S14, S42 is written as S24 is again written as minus S14, S43 is written as S34. So these 3 and 4 are isolated ports, S44 is 0, it is a matched port. So first you have to make the adjustments like this. In the S matrix, we have to find out all these values and substitute it. This will complete this S matrix. Now, from next property, from the unitary property of S matrix, what is the unitary property? S matrix multiplied by its complex conjugate matrix is equal to identity matrix. So this is what you have to write, the from unitary property of S matrix. So we can write like this. So this is the property of S matrix. So now substitute S and S complex conjugate and equal to identity matrix. So we can write like this. So we can write the same matrix, S11, S12, S13, S14, first row, S12, S22, S13 minus S14, S13, 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 0, 0, S14 minus S14, 0, 0, and its complex conjugate matrix S11 star, S12 star, S13 star, S14 star, S12 star, S22 star, S13 star, minus S14 star, S13 star, S13 star, 0, 0, S14 star, minus S14 star, 0, 0. So that is equal to identity matrix is 1, 0, 0, 0. So 0, 1, 0, 0. So 0, 0, 0, 1. So sorry, in fact, 0, 0, 1, 0. And 0, 0, 0, 1. So let us make these rows. So these are the four rows, R1, R2, R3, R4. So these are the columns C1, C2, C3, C4. So equate R1, C1 is equal to 1, R2, C2 is equal to 1, R3, C3 is equal to 1, R4, C4 is equal to 1. So by making this multiplication, so therefore what we can write, R1, C1, by multiplying R1 and C1 and equating it to 1, you can take this S11 square, you can write S11 square plus S12 square plus S13 square plus S14 square is equal to 1, say equation 1. Similarly, R2 multiplied by C2, R2 multiplied by C2 will give S12 square plus S22 square plus S13 square plus S14 square is equal to 1, say equation 2. Similarly, R3 C3, we multiply R3 C3 here. So R3 C3, so we can multiply here S13 square plus S13 square is equal to 1, say equation 3, and R4 C4, multiply R4 by C4. So you multiply R4 by C4, you will get S14 square plus S14 square is equal to 1, say equation 4. So these are the very simple equations. Now, so from 3 and 4 we will get one value. From 3, what you can write? 2 magnitude of S13 square is equal to 1. So from which S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. We can write like this. S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. Similarly, from equation 4, you can see that 2 into S14 square, so that is equal to 1, from which S14, magnitude of S14 is equal to 1 by root 2. So we can write this one also. We have got two values, magnitude of S13, magnitude of S14 is equal to 1 by root 2. Now, we can see by comparing 1 and 2, by comparing 1 and 2, what you can conclude, what from, you can check that S13, S14, from this S11 is equal to S22. So this is another important relation, S11 is equal to S22. So this observation you can make, S11 is equal to S22. Now, so another relation, from R4 multiplied by C1, R4 multiplied by C1 coming here. So you can see this R4 R4 multiplied by C1, that means the sum of products of any row multiplied by complex conjugates of any column is equal to 0. From the property of S matrix, the sum of products of any row multiplied by complex conjugates of any other column is 0. That is R4 C1 is equal to 0. So from this we can write it as S14 into S11 star, S14 into S11 star minus minus S minus S14 into S12 star 0 0. So that is equated to 0. S14 into S11 star minus S14 into S12 star minus S14 into S12 star, so is equal to 0. From this what you can make, S14 is take it as common, S14 S11 star minus S12 star is equal to 0. Since S14 is 1 by root which is not equal to 0, from this equation what you can write, S11 star minus S12 star is equal to 0. So from which S11 star is equal to S12 star, from which so if you take complex conjugates on both sides, S11 is equal to S12. So these are the factors you have to observe. So from this you can see this S11 is equal to S22. In this matrix, see, very simple. Already we have got S13, S14 values. You can see S13 is 1 by root 2, S14 is 1 by root 2, S11 is equal to S22 we got, and as well as S11 is equal to S1 S12. Simply see that this is 1 by root 2, S14 is 1 by root 2, S11 is equal to S22 we got, and S11 is equal to S12 we got. So substitute all these values. So before that, substitute this relation S11 is equal to S12 in this relation, S11 is equal to S2 in equation 1. So substituting in equation 1, so S11 square, keep it as it is, S12 square is written as S11 square plus S13 is 1 by root 2, it will become R square 1 by 2, plus S14 is 1 by root 2, square it 1 by 2, so which is equated to 1. From this expression you can clearly see that 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, so therefore it will come out S11 is equal to 0. Substitute all these properties in S matrix, so therefore finally S matrix is given by S is equal to what you can write, S is equal to S11 is 0, S12 it is, since it is 0, 1 by root 2 we can write, so this we can write 1 by root 2, this value is 0, this value is 0, so this is 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2, so again, so dot of these values, 1 by root 2, 0, so 0, 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2, so 0, 0. So this is what you have to derive, the S matrix. So this is the S matrix of, magic T. Let us find out these relations. So that is from this equation, so that is B is equal to S matrix into A matrix. So A are the inputs to the ports, and as we explained, B are the outputs of the ports. So now you can check this. So by substituting this, what you can write it as? So this is written as, you can check this. The left side is written as B1, B2, B3, B4, outputs of 4 ports. The S matrix is very simple, 0, so 0, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, 0, so 0, what are the inputs? A1, A2, A3, A4. By multiplying this, we can write the output equations as, so B1 is equal to, you can check that 0 into 0, A3 by root 2,
plus a4 by root 2. This is the first one. Let us check out b2. So what is b2? So b2 is equal to 0, 0. So you can write it as a3 by root 2 minus a4 by root 2. Similarly, b3. You can check it b3 as, you can check b3 as a1 by root 2 plus a2 by root 2. Similarly, finally b4 is written as, b4 is written as a1 by root 2 minus a2 by root 2. So these are the very very important equation which with the help of with these equations we can explain the operation of magic tea completely. Let us take different cases here. Case 1. So that means if a4 is not equal to 0, that means we are applying input to, as explained in the previous e plenty and h plenty, if the input is applied to a4 only and a1 is equal to a2 is equal to a3 is equal to 0, so that means if input is applied to only port 4, let us check out this, what happens to b1. B1 will come out as, so b1 will come out as, because a3 is equal to 0, a4 is not equal to, b4 will come out as a4 by root 2 and b2 will come out as a3 is 0 minus a4 by root 2 minus a4 by root 2. Let us check out b3. So b3, so you can check out a1 0, a2 0, this is 0, and b4, so b4 will come out as a1 0, a2 0, 0. So you can check that this is the property of e plenty. So you can check that the outputs at port 1 and port 2 are of equal magnitude with 180 degree space difference. So that is the property of e plenty. With the help of this equation we can express the property of e plenty. Let us take case 2. In case 2 we apply input to a3 and the remaining a1 is equal to a2 is equal to a4 is equal to 0. That means we apply input to only port 3, that is HR, to all the remaining inputs are 0. Then let us check out what is b1 will be. So you can check that b1, a4 is equal to 0, it will become a3 by root 2. And b2, you can check out, since a4 is 0, it will become a3 by root 2. You can check that a1 and a2 are 0, a1 and a2 are 0. So therefore, b3 is equal to 0 and b4 is equal to 0. So from this property, you can check the property of HOM or H plenty. You can see that when the input is applied to port 3 or HOM, the outputs obtained at port 1 and port 2 are of equal magnitude with same phase, and no output is obtained at port 4. Since port 3 and port 4 are isolated ports. Next, check the case 3. Suppose if you apply inputs to a3 is equal to a4 is equal to a, let us call, that means we are applying inputs to port 3 and port 4, em and hr, and a1 is equal to 0 and a2 is equal to 0. So that means we are applying inputs to hr and em and equal magnitude, and a1 is equal to a2 is equal to 0. Let us see what happens in this case. So that means b1, so b1 is equal to, you can check that b1 is equal to a3 is equal to a4 is equal to a, it will become 2 into a by root 2. So let us check out b2. So b2, a3 a a4 a a by root 2 a by root 2, so b2 will become 0. So let us check out b3. So b3 is 0, a1 a2 are 0, b4 is 0. So this is a very very interesting property. You can check from this diagram, you can check that if the input is applied to port 3 and port 4, of equal amplitude, and in phase, you can check that only output is obtained at this port, the output is not obtained at this port. You can check that the output is not obtained if the input is applied at this port and this port of equal magnitude and phase. You can see the only b1 is obtained,
So B2 is equal to 0, B2 is equal to 0. Since port 3 and port 4 are isolated, B3 is 0, B4 is 0. So that observation you can make from these equations. Let us check out case 4. If A1 is equal to A2 is equal to, so that means we are applying inputs to port 1 and port 2. We are not applying inputs to port 3 and port 4, E4 and H4. Let us check out what is B1 is. Let us check out what is B1. So B1, so A3 and A4 is equal to 0. So therefore B1 is equal to 0. So B2, A3, A4 are 0. So B2 is equal to 0. So what is B3? So let us check out what is B3. So B3 is equal to, so A1 is equal to A, A2 is equal to A. So it will become 2 into A by root 2 and B4. Let us check out what is B4 value. So A by root 2, A by root 2, it will come out 0. So this is another very interesting property. You can make observation. So that means if you apply inputs to these ports, port 1 and port 2 of equal amplitude, so the output will obtain at this, because addition of these two and its phase, no output is obtained at this port. So from this property, if the inputs are applied at port 1 and port 2, the output at port 3 is addition of this, and in phase, that if these two cancels out at this port, that is what you have to observe from this case 4. Similarly, last case, you can check the last case, case 5, observe these cases very carefully. Case 5, we apply input to only one port, A1 is equal to A, the remaining inputs are 0, A2, A3, A4 is equal to 0. Let us check out what happens in this case. A1 is equal to A. So from this B1, A3 is equal to 0, A4 is equal to 0. So B1 is equal to 0. B1 is equal to 0. What is B2? B2 is also 0. So B2 is also 0. So then check out B3. B3 is equal to, you can check that A2 is equal to 0. It will become A by root 2. So B3 is become A by root 2. So and B4 will become A by root 2. So another very, very interesting property, you can check that. If you apply input to only this port 1, you can check that this input will not come here. This input is equally divided into this port and this port. So that is this property. That means if you apply input to this port, generally what you expect, this input will not come here. This input is equally divided between these two ports and they are in phase. So these various observations you can observe from these 5 cases, very, very important cases. These 5 cases will entirely explain this operation of what happens when the inputs are given to different ports, how this H+T or magic T will behave is completely explained with the help of these 5 cases. So this is the magic T or hybrid T, very, very important topic in microwave engineering subject.